Let's get it.
Guess who's possessed?
And if you don't know,
let me break it down for you again.
Okay, party people in the house, you're about to witness something you've never witnessed before.
Include as soon as the album I'ma drop. It'll make your bitch nipples as hard as rock. Giving head to the Glock. Pretend it's hard cut. Splashing niggas, I came slow through the block. The original visual individual. 10 times platinum, your career's looking critical. Rich from this, motherfuck being a criminal. Look in your bitch eyes, the vibe is subliminal. You wanna freestyle? Fuck that. I need at least 7 figures to even touch that. But since everybody was underestimating my format, I dropped ill bomb and now niggas want more of that. Ain't a rapper dead or alive fucking with me. Ask the last bitch that tried to come and get me. Talk about paper, I can talk about broads. I can talk about movies, I can talk about awards. Fuck the fantasies, yo, I got all four. In 2001, I'll be mine by law. Why I name it greatest of all times? Because for 15 years, I kept y'all standing in line. Loving the way I shine in my lyrics combined with the ruggedest, illest beats that Def Jam can find. Fuck them other niggas with they 9 or 10 hits. My hits run deep as the emotions of your bitch. Back in the days, it was the M5 stick, but now the Bentley is all. Get more whores on the dick. This one's for Clue. And my Rikers Island niggas that remember when I came through. The Bing, OBCC, HDM2, C74, Little Nazi in the crew. Y'all niggas come home. Word up, the new album gonna be the shit, baby. Ain't no doubt about it. E Pluribus Unum. Out of many, one, the GOAT, greatest of all time.
Yo, what's up, everybody? Thank you for listening, downloading, streaming, and sharing the Encyclopedia Hip Hop Podcast. I really appreciate it. This is Eclectic at Tweet Rhymes Life on Twitter. Speaking of Twitter and social media, what a lot of younger people like to do is discuss, debate, argue, and yell at each other about who's the GOAT, greatest of all time. Now, in this case, we're going to talk about MCs. We're going to talk about rappers. We're going to talk about hip-hop music performing artists. And it's hard to say who is the greatest of all time. It's hard to say who's the greatest of all time in anything, sports, music, whatever. Because it's different eras, things change, and it's not the same playing field all the time. It's easier to say who's the best in their era, their run, their decade, maybe even just the year that they came out. But what I try to do is come up with criteria, because there's never criteria when people say, hey, this person is the greatest. Why? Makes songs that I like. Shut up, you're stupid. There's never any criteria. So what I tried to do is come up with criteria for me, much like I have criteria for determining if someone made a classic album or not. I have a scoring system. Same thing here. Criteria. I made it 10 different things that I'm looking at. And maybe in a future episode, I'll see if there's going to be a scoring, but this is at least talking points, debate points, 10 solid things that if you're going to be considered the greatest of all time, you have to be able to check these boxes. So without filibustering anymore, let's get to it. First off, you have to have at least 10 years in. There's no need to discuss a great if they haven't been around for a while. Nothing is great or a classic immediately. You gotta have some kind of tenure, and a decade in, you know, that weeds out the flash in the pan, the one-hit wonders, the three-hit wonders. 10 years in. Dope. 10 years in. Number two. 5 consensus timeless classic singles. And by consensus, I mean if you're around people who have respected hip-hop opinions, you know, like, look, I respect what you guys think about hip-hop. Consensus. And they would have to agree that this person has 5 timeless. They don't have to agree on the same 5. That's even better for the artist. They say, nah, this is a classic. You come up with 10. It's great. Doesn't have to be the same 5, but they have to agree that they have at least 5 timeless classic singles. Not that was the shit when it came out. That it was the shit 5 years after it came out. Or 2 years at least. Jesus. The third, they have to have 3 consensus timeless classic albums. They have to have them. And if you can't have Fife, can't be the greatest rapper of all time. He only had 1 solo album. We're talking solos. Now we could put them in the group category, Tribe Called Quest, but we talking solo? No, if you don't have 3 solo albums, I can't consider you one of the greatest. So the consensus. So someone might say, now this is a classic, this is a classic, this is a classic. Another person might say, nah, these 3 are classics. You get enough people, and the consensus is they have 3 classic albums. Okay, let's continue. Let's talk. Let's have a conversation. The fourth thing, 3 dope story songs. See, storytelling is vital. It's a building block of hip hop music. This may be personal for me, but if you don't have at least 3 dope story rhymes, I'm talking a story, long form narrative, I can't put you up there with the greats. That's not to say that you're not great. It's not to say that you're not one of the best. I can't put you up there as the greatest of all time if you can't tell a story with the rhymes like that. 5. Brought something to hip hop music that wasn't there before. See, when talking about the greats, after they retire, when they get older, or after they're gone, you should be able to point to at least 1, really multiple things, but at least 1 thing that they brought to hip hop music that wasn't there prior. Or at the bare minimum, innovated something. Because that's, you know, that's what greats do. They also give back to the art form. And you can tell, you can see it, that, you know, the art form is better for it. Or it changed a little bit in a positive manner because of them. If you want to be a great, you know, that's where we're going with it. 6, I think we had 6. Versatility while maintaining their own style. What I mean by that is being able to rhyme and make songs about multiple things and be on tracks with multiple MCs or different MCs and still sound like yourself. In the beginning, biting wasn't allowed. It should never been, but late 90s and beyond changed that. In the 90s, they called it paying homage to a style or showing versatility. I disagree. It's not versatility. I think a great should be able to get busy on a beat or with another MC and fit in while sounding like themselves. Form of evolution while maintaining identity. Otherwise, you just sound like everybody else. What's dope about that? You know what I'm saying? It's like, Chuck D is going to sound like Chuck D even if he's on a song with Dos Effects and they prime. Because that's what you do. You sound like you. You don't iggity. I mean, you could iggity, but you got to sound like you iggitying. Next is legacy. What they left to the music. A lot of people like to get into impact and what these people made other people think. I don't care about that. I only care about the music. I'm only talking about music. If you want to talk about some other stuff, we can talk about some other stuff. I am talking about the greatest MC of all time and MC rapping, making music. You know, when you talk about Jordan, you say he's the greatest on time. I don't care about him gambling off court. Who cares? Nobody cares. So, legacy, what they left. This is almost like that what they brought something that wasn't there, but it's what they left. Because it's one thing to bring and be the first to do something and affect hip hop like that. But if it never worked or fizzled out, you know, it's unfortunate. It's not a legacy. It's like, oh man, they caught fire with that for that 1 year. And then nobody did that no more. It was a wrap. Something that you can still see in hip hop music that they pioneered. Even if it's not the exact same, you can trace it back to them. So even if it's not exactly, hey, they were the first to do this, no one's doing that anymore, but they're doing a version of that. And mostly because of them. If that makes any sense. Then we have being able to rock different decades or eras. You know, being able to adapt and reinvent while maintaining. So this is like maintaining your own style, but this separates a one-hit wonder, a one-style wonder, a one-type of fan wonder from the others. I'm giving a 10-year minimum, so that's one decade. The ability to remain relevant and dope for more than one decade is a great trait. Not to sound dated or outdone by new and up-and-coming acts, or, you know, being able to still make music and give you a hit while being out of their prime era. Like, look, being able to drop 30 on you even though this is my 16th year. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. Songwriting and creativity. One, being able to write your own lyrics, but the creativity to have a variety of subject matter. Not necessarily different genres, but the ability to appeal to different types of ears if needed. You know what I'm saying? So you got people, oh, they talk that this stuff, but they also got this stuff. And sometimes they'll give you some of this stuff, and it's all dope. That's great shit. It's like having a post game and an outside game, depending on how the defense plays you. Being able to complete short passes, to bomb or run, depending on what the defense gives you. But being successfully dope while doing it all. When you can take the listener to new or different places while being dope and sounding like yourself. That's greatness. And lastly, I think this is 10, commercial and block success, respect. This is the least important to me, but it's still vital if you want to talk greatest of all time. It's like calling an athlete the GOAT, but they never won a title. While it doesn't necessarily define their skill set because it's a team game, just like winning a Grammy or selling a million doesn't directly reflect on your wordplay because it's all subjective. And some people pay for those awards. And some people, you know, do behind the scenes shit to ship a million. It's still, you know, if you don't really satisfy a category, you can't be considered. You know what I'm saying? So it's like if an athlete was hated by everyone or seen as a cheater or was a known cheater, all that could be true and they could still be considered one of the best or considered great, but not the greatest ever. So you have to have some record success. I don't care about the awards, but the sales or the critical acclaim, be revered by the peers as dope. Cause that used to be all you cared about. Nah, they think I'm dope. The people that I listen to tell me that I'm dope. That's just really all that mattered. So being revered by the peers is dope. And seen as one of the best. So that's my personal 10-point system of determining the GOAT status of an MC. And what I'll do is either invite people on the show who say they have a person who is the GOAT, and we'll discuss these points and see if they qualify. Or I'll come up with a name and go through the paces and you know, say what I think and why or why not. The more you have in a category, the better it is. If you don't really satisfy a category, you can't be considered. If for nothing else, it's a good basis for a great debate. And we already know who I think the GOAT is. So maybe I can do that one first. Or not. I'm not sure. But, you know, just the 10 years in, it's going to eliminate a lot of your young little squirty quirts. They're out. They're not. They haven't been rapping for 10 years, so shut up. They're not the greatest. You see what I'm saying? People don't do stories anymore. They're knocked out. They're not the greatest. We're talking all time. We're not talking last year. We're not talking the greatest on the XXL freshman cover. We're talking period. So if you want to talk period, it's going to have to be some difficulty. It's going to have to be some harsh truths. It's going to have to be some hard criteria. Or else everyone's the greatest. Shut up. Anyway, that's what I got. Until the next time. I'm leaning back in the cockpit. I drop big bombs. These bastards can't stop it. Hot dance. I'm a prophet for profit. Once I decide to lock it, frontin' on me is toxic. Go pop on haters. Love songs and rock hit. Throw them out, they chuckers when I spit. They ain't bout ish. I'm so ruthless and cunning when the drummer is drumming. Y'all see, I got your man running. LL the boss, like Luke with the force. My technique. Ugly, dirty like rugby. Drop jewels like Yoda, my young students love me. All rappers are under, not one of them above me. I rip it, I blow the whole house down on your big mouth clowns. You can come and see me now, my G. You are now rocking with the GOAT. Throw your hands in the air, have a sip, take a jump. You are now rocking with the GOAT. Go ahead, do your two step, put your hand in your coat. You are now rocking with the GOAT. Throw your hands in the air, try to wave away the smoke. That's it. You are now rocking with the GOAT. Go ahead, do your two step while I let these haters know. Better back down, listen good with both ears. Keep your mouth shut, fall back like broke chairs. How can they deliver like me? I'm so rare. Your man had a pretty good run, I don't care. So far ahead that I'm counting in light years. I mean, lightning strikes longer than your career. With some arrogant superstars, you like that? Yeah. In the club, make a ruckus. Little mama, wanna touch us. I'm a grown man. Most boys like Kobe at the Ruckus. I play Chris Tucker, rush all you suckers. You're way too lame. I'll show you game. Oh, yeah. Just in case y'all forgot my name. I'm the G.O.A.T. Much hotter lately, ripping all comers as co-creator, chop the break beat. Farmers Boulevard is up in here thick, and I help Russell hustle, you can go ask Rick. Mike Jack, you are now rocking with the GOAT. Throw your hands in the air, have a sip, take a jump. Hot dance, you are now rocking with the GOAT. Go ahead, do your two step, put your hands in your coat. Play a hard leg, you are now rocking with the GOAT. Throw your hands in the air, try to wave away the smoke. That's it. The monster is back. They probably put a hit on me for murdering the track. They tried to flip on me, they thought I wasn't coming back. They sealed the jaw and then they threw me in the back. Ran me in circles, I came back like that. I floated to the top, fully loaded on cock. Cause once you get the oven this hot, he don't stop. These frauds wanna sell you the hype, but don't cop. I give you the pure shot.
I'm the L.
Motherfucking L forever. What they saying on the internet, I rip whoever. For the last 10 years or so, I loved them better. But I'm back, you sick. Time to get your clique together, dummy. I
play hard.
I goes in for real. The odds are always with me when I spin the wheel. And you could've rocked with me, but you're not real. So when I polish off the plaque, I'll let you know how it feels.
Oh, Mike Jack.
You are now rocking with the GOAT. Throw your hands in the air, have a sip, take a jump.
Hot dance.
You are now rocking with the GOAT. Go ahead, do your two step, put your hand in your coat.
Play a hard leg.
You are now rocking with the GOAT. Throw your hands in the air, try.
gotta let these haters know.
Mic check.
You are now rocking with the GOAT.
I'm tired.